switch it over now to our guests in the studio who've been patiently with us for the first half of the show. And I'm really excited to have Ali Ortiz here and Julia Suarez joining us. And we're going to talk a little bit about the Pasofino breed. Welcome to the show. Thank you for being with us.
Thanks for having us.
Tell us
a little bit about the background of the Pasofino horse.
They go back to the days of Christopher Columbus, and they took a barb, a Spanish chariot, and Andalusian, and created this horse with a very smooth ride. The horses were part of his cavalry back then.
How wonderful. Yeah. Such a comfortable breed. Tell us a little bit about the gaits. They have some gaits they're born with.
They are correct? Born, and right, we'll show a video now of the babies. Basically, it's a 4-beat lateral gait where no 2 feet ever hit the ground at the same time. It's like shock absorbers.
And that's what makes that's them, a good yeah, description.
And that's what makes them so smooth. And there's, you know, under saddle, there's no trot. And they're always smooth. And they ended up in the 1500s. These horses went on eventually. They went to Puerto Rico. Then the horses went to Colombia. Eventually, there was a Frenchman that actually brought the first Pasofino to Puerto Rico. And then there was the Spanish-American War in the late 1700s. And the soldiers that were there fell in love with this breed of horse. And they eventually started bringing the horses to the United States.
Wow.
Yeah.
And how long have they been in America?
They actually, in Ocala, they began coming in the early 1960s.
Really?
Yes.
So quite some time.
Yes.
And it's almost become like the Pasofino capital of the world here, right? Or at least of America, for sure.
No, we are. Marion County is the county with the most Pasofinos in the whole United States. We have the most Pasofino farms, the most Pasofino trainers.
It's amazing.
It's huge here. Yes.
Now, when they're born, they already naturally have this comfortable gait?
Yes, they do. You can see the babies traveling behind the mother, with all their feet moving so fast, it's hard sometimes with your eye to keep track of exactly what they're doing. See, you see the babies right there?
Oh my gosh, that's so cute.
It's so fluent what they do that your eyes can't hardly follow the legs sometimes. And you know, it's funny, I think what we battle most in our breed is that people that see these horses, a lot of people think they're man-made, Lisa. And there is nothing man-made about them. This is what they do when they're babies.
They just get up and do it.
All the time. Yeah, it's amazing. It's amazing.
So cute.
And you can take an older horse, too, and lead it. See? That one's getting older there.
Oh, my, yeah.
Yeah.
Look at that.
They're a spirited breed.
Yes.
But they're a gentle breed.
Yes, they're lovely. Now, they're generally smaller than...
They normally run around 13.3 to about 14.2, but you do have some 15-hand passels.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
but it's more, and I see guys riding them. They don't look too big for them.
No, it's funny. People call and say, my husband is 6 foot tall. Do you not think he's going to look big on a passel? We say, no, you know why? Because they're so elegant.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I personally used to show a mare that barely met the height requirement. She barely did. She did, because there was a height requirement at some of the international shows. And I would laugh because we'd go to these shows and they would measure a lot of the horses. And I would say to my husband, they never measure because she had such a tall neck carriage.
Mm-hmm.
They look a lot bigger.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
They are so graceful. You're right.
So they can handle a tall rider.
Julia, you also are a rider?
Yes. I'm the OPFHA secretary. I was born into the Pasofinos because my family, they're four brothers. And they're some of the pioneers of the horses here in Ocala. They've been here for like 40 years, and they came from Puerto Rico. My dad and his four brothers are Pasofino trainers. So they've been here for years. They've seen Ocala grow. They've seen the Pasofinos grow in Ocala. So I'm very much in it.
Is your dad Jorge?
Jaime.
One
of them.
Yeah. Okay.
One of them.
The Suarez family is very well known in the Pasofino world, for sure. Yeah.
So we're lucky to have our entire family really loves it and is passionate about it. So we're hoping that my generation continues to grow and show what we want to show the whole world about the Pasofinos. So I'm excited.
And were you around them since you were little?
Since
you were born
Miami,
into it
in
as well?
In Miami. And I started riding when I was 11. My father got me my first horse, and I've been involved ever since.
And it's always been a Paso?
Always been a Paso.
Really?
And Julia is also our model for the Ocala Cup International Promo.
She made me do that.
But very appropriate. It's actually a perfect, beautiful fit, wasn't it? So talk a little bit about some of the riding disciplines that Pasadenas are involved in. Obviously, they're very popular for trail riding.
They are, because of their smoothness, once again.
And I see them all the time going up and down like 326.
Yes.
Yeah.
Around, I see people on the side of the road, and I'm always like, there's a Pasadena, I can tell, because they look so comfortable, they're not moving.
At the shows, we have a pleasure division, which that division, the horses have to do a nice, relaxed walk, loose rein. Basically, it's a show horse, but it's like you're out having a great time while you show this horse. And then we got the performance division, which is more collected, more elegant, more energetic. The walk is animated, more animated than the pleasure. And then we have the classic fino division, which is our highest division. And some people may not like this, and some people love it. Their feet move really fast, but they go nowhere. The fast forward movement is
really
limited. Yes, they go, it takes them a longer time to get from point A to point B. And
wow.
Their feet move really fast, and they, all three divisions, we go on the sounding board at the show.
I was actually going to ask you about the board next.
Yes.
Can you tell us about the board?
Yeah, the reason for the sounding board is one of the tools that the judges use to make sure that that horse is perfectly synchronized and engaged. So it's huge.
So they can hear that?
Yes, you can hear it as a judge, and if it's off, you can hear it. So that's really, really
important.
Can
you hear that, or do you have to be really...
No, I can
hear it.
I'm actually a judge.
Oh, well, you? Okay, so you can hear it.
So yes, you do, but you know, you got to... When it's noisy, sometimes the horses are so quick that you really got to have a close ear. Because to be sure, but yes, that's so the sounding board is basically a tool that they use for judging.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's really cool. Yeah. Now, looking at like different colors, are there a lot of different colors? I notice in some of the videos we've watched, there's been a variety. Is there a color that's preferred in the breed? Or
every color. They have every color. We have everything from... gray, black, bay, chestnut, pintos, roans, every color, you name it, we have it in the breed.
Wonderful. So you show?
Yes.
You show?
Yes.
Okay, you do show as well?
Yes.
So you guys will be competing
very
soon.
Yes. Yep.
In the next segment, we're actually going to talk a little bit about the Ocala Cup and share a little bit about what people can see there, which is pretty exciting. But the Pasadena breed, really a neat breed. I've had a Tennessee Walker for years and years and years, so I am very comfortable on a gated horse, so I can certainly understand how you, but I've never ridden a Pasadena.
Oh, you need to do that.
Need to do that. I think I'll come and
you
see
you. For sure.
Definitely.
Need to.
We are going to come back in just a few minutes on the Horse Talk Show presented by Palm Chevrolet. And we have another two segments with these ladies, so we're going to hear a little bit more about the Pasadenas and about the Ocala Cup. Stay with us on the Horse Talk Show.
The Equine Performance Center Ocala, with numerous success stories and featuring the most advanced equine conditioning and rehab equipment available in the world today, is striving to be the best in the nation. Find them on the web at epcrehab.com and like them on Facebook now. Happy, healthy horses live in fly-free barns. Don't allow annoying flies and mosquitoes to cause disease and health issues getting between you and your horse's happiness and health. Get your fly misting system now from Acres Pest Control. With over 20 years of pest control experience, family owned, licensed and insured. Get your free inspection with Acres, the best for your acres. Check them out now at acrespestcontrol.com. That's A-K-E-R-S pestcontrol.com.
This show was brought to you in part by TT Distributors, dedicated to bringing their customers the largest selection of quality horse supplements, products, and farrier supplies in Florida at affordable prices. Also online at ttdistributors.com. This hour of the Horse Talk Show is presented by Palm Chevrolet in Ocala, where the entire team is committed to making your experience in sales and service hassle-free and easier than ever with no games or gimmicks. Come in and visit on Southwest College Road or online at palmchevrolet.com. A second to none experience with all the amenities. Palm Chevy, find new roads.
Welcome back to the Horse Talk Show.
You never heard of a talking horse? Well, listen to this.
With your host, Louisa Barton.
What does it feel like to be in love with a horse?
Presented this hour by Palm Chevrolet, your hometown Chevy store. Now, here's your pretty, pretty Louisa.
switched on. You're a bit of all right. Yes.
I feel like I'm like looking at
back on the Horse Talk Show presented by Palm Chevrolet, your hometown Chevy experience. Thank you to Larson Farms, our broadcast sponsor, Idaho's finest alfalfa, Louise Barton in the studio. Got a couple of great guests with me today, just chatting a little bit about the Pasofino breed and how they have that natural, comfortable gait. I'm sure you've seen them out and about around the horse capital. Being ridden and enjoyed on the trails. I certainly have when I've been trail riding. I've seen them out there when I'm on sunny and always think they look wonderful, comfortable and fun, a little spicy, a little fun. Got a little get up and go. I like to see that. But we've been talking a little bit about the Ocala Cup. I've got Ali Ortiz here and Julia. Mm-hmm. Am I saying it right?
Yeah, Julia.
Julia Suarez here. And we've been talking about the Ocala Cup. It's an international event coming up in December. Tell us a little bit about how the Ocala Cup got started, Alex.
Actually, we started back in 2018. In the Pasofino world, there's a professional World Cup show that is huge, and every 2 years, it's in a different country of origin of the Pasofinos. So it rotates from Dominican Republic to Puerto Rico to Colombia to U.S. So on an off year when there's no World Cup, because the World Cup is always around November, we decided to start having this Ocala Cup in Ocala, and the first one was November 2018. So now this is our second one, and it's going to be huge. Right now, Julia's in charge of tables, and we have right now
sold out
300 and over 360 stalls. We have bring portables.
Really?
Yeah, we're hoping we get to 400.
Wow.
But right now we're at 360.
We're sold out with tables.
So people are coming with their horses from all over?
There's horses that have been flown in from Puerto Rico. They go to Miami and they come here. We have horses coming from Pennsylvania. We have horses coming from Miami.
We have competitors coming from Aruba, Switzerland.
It's turning out to be a fantastic show.
We're excited.
So excited.
Oh my gosh, that's amazing.
Yeah.
Somebody should measure the economic impact. It's got to be big.
Yeah, Marion County is sponsoring our show.
That's good. I was going to say, I mean, that's a big impact.
Yes,
on the,
it really is.
Because you're going to have people spending money while they're here.
We're
right?
really excited, Luisa, because we have, you know, in Florida, there's two big regions. There's a Miami region and our region. But our region is the one with the most farms, the most trainers. And we really are working on Marion County, Ocala being the capital of the Pasofino industry.
How exciting.
And I think we're in the right direction. This show is going to be huge because I think it's going to be so great that after this show, we're really opening a lot of doors where people are going to be just coming in here a lot to look at our passes.
Yeah. Maybe there'll be people moving here.
I think so.
I don't know if I mentioned I'm a realtor as well. I sell
farms. Oh, I didn't know that. Really?
Awesome.
Really? Oh, I definitely think that there's going to be people moving here and buying farms.
Yes, I have my license with Showcase Properties, and
really?
Happy to help them if they want to move here.
Yeah, we have a big deal coming to our show. We have three judges coming from Colombia, South America. There are three of the top judges in the world.
Really?
And they're going to be judging the Fino division on Saturday and Sunday.
So how many classes are there in the show?
206.
Yeah.
Yeah, 206 classes.
Mm-hmm. Oh, my God.
Friday to Sunday.
Yeah, the way it works is Friday, there's a pre-Ocala Cup.
And it's a whole show on its own, classes and championships on Friday. And then Saturday will just be classes, another show, starting on Saturday, and then championships on Sunday. So it's kind of a pre-Ocala Cup. It kind of gives you a chance to compete first. And then Saturday and Sunday is where it's like games on.
That's nice. So they get a little chance to kind of get comfortable and settled in.
Exactly.
Wow. And so all those horses are staying in the livestock.
Yes. Yep.
And on Sunday we have the red rose flower blankets and the gold cup. So it's our big day. Sunday's the big championship day.
It's
free admission. Fun for the whole family.
That's wonderful. Yeah. So talk about, obviously, COVID concerns. I don't even like to talk about it.
Yes, we don't either.
But we do have to cover it because we have to reassure people that you have some measures in place to prevent spreading of that.
Of course, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, so we're going to have mandatory masks, of course, and we are going to be having the temperature taken at the gate and following social distancing as much as we can, but really the mask mandatory is going to be, since we do feel like there's going to be a big crowd coming, we want to ensure, and there's going to be signs all over ensuring that there's masks, and we're going to have some sheriffs right there as well. So Good. We're hoping everyone's going to abide. I think at this point, people are so used to them. I know I go to the grocery store and I'm like, oh, my mask. Ali did it when she was coming here. So
I know. I forget sometimes when I leave the grocery store and I'm walking to my truck and I'm like, oh, I've still got it on. I can take it off.
Yeah.
And then I realize that's probably how people get in their vehicles and drive off. And I was in Kentucky last week and you can't go anywhere in Kentucky without a mask unless you're eating or drinking. It's the only time you can have a mask
off. That's basically what's going to be at the show.
Yeah.
And that's pretty much why I drank too much that weekend. But anyway, because I could take it off. And
I have a funny story. We had a show in August that was a small show, and this is a true story. Our cleaning girls are so amazing that we had only one bathroom open at that show because it was a small show. And they would literally peek in and see who was going in which stall in the bathroom so they could go after and clean. They were wiping.
Obsessively
they
clean.
They were really good. They were just cleaning and cleaning, disinfecting all the benches in the barn. They were amazing.
That's wonderful.
They're really hardworking girls.
You know, that makes people feel more comfortable. And I think at this point, the things that people are enjoying being part of are outdoor activities. Things where they can be outside and around animals and watch horses and all kind of things, because I think people feel much more comfortable outdoors. I think if you've added a lot of really good safety measures to that and you're checking people's temperatures, then I think that's great. You know, it's wonderful.
We think that's another reason that this is going to be so huge, because in our breed, we've had to cancel a lot of big shows throughout the year because of COVID. So this one's like the first really big one. We had our nationals. It was nice, it was big, but not as big as maybe past years. Yes. So this one's gonna be, I think, huge, because it's really like all that excitement is accumulating over, and we're like, okay, when are we gonna have a show? And finally, we're gonna have our big show. So
I know. I think I usually attend a lot of races throughout the year. You know, cover the Ocala connections to them. And this year, because of COVID, I haven't been at too many races. And when I got to the Breeders' Cup, I was like, yeah.
Were they really strict over there?
Yes, they were taking everybody's temperature, no masks off unless you're eating or drinking. Normally there's about, at Keeneland, I think there's about 50 or 60,000 usually that watch it. It was under 5,000 people, just the owners, trainers, and a few sponsors.
That's how our nationals was.
And you have to register beforehand and let them know you're going.
And then when you go in, they take your temperature. But they take your temperature everywhere in Kentucky, even restaurants and everything.
Oh, they do, really?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, in Lexington, you can't go anywhere without that. They check everything. But I think if you put all those things in place, you know, we can go on with having fun and going to some of these, you know, these horse events that we enjoy. Because honestly, for many people, it's entertainment, it's therapy, it's what they love doing. You know, you're outdoors. I think it's great if you can, you know.
At Nationals, we said it was USCF, and they didn't have all the cleaning measures that we do. I don't believe it. Masks were mandatory, and there was a lot of us there, and nobody got sick. Absolutely nobody got sick.
There's some things that are funny, because, like, washing your hands, like, were you not doing that before? That's a little gross.
I know.
It is.
I cannot tell you how many public bathrooms I've been in my life prior to COVID where I was like, I cannot believe she just left the bathroom without washing her hands.
Exactly. You should be already doing that.
Yes. So apparently there is a mass hand washing going on now, which could be a good thing. We are going to take our last break on the Horse Talk Show. We're going to come back. We'll have one more segment with these ladies, and we're going to wrap it up, talk a little bit more about the Pasifinos and the Ocala Cup, and that'll be it for this week. So stay with us on the Horse Talk Show. We'll be right back.
World-class equine rehab promoting faster recovery is available at the Equine Performance Center Ocala. Hyperbaric oxygen therapy, an underwater treadmill, a saltwater spa, an aquapacer, MagnaWave, a vibration plate, swimming pool, massage and laser therapies. With post-surgical care, memberships, packages and BOGOs, EPC delivers a rejuvenated horse through proven and innovative rehab. Like Equine Performance Center now on Facebook and find them on the web at epcrehab.com. Acres Pest Control offers a variety of professional pest control services for farm owners, residential and commercial customers. Control pests, fire ants, mosquitoes, rodents and more. Also offering fly misting systems with speedy response, friendly service and effective pest control techniques. No contracts and affordable, effective pest control. Acres, A-K-E-R-S, is the best for your acres. Check them out now at acrespestcontrol.com.
This show was brought to you in part by TT Distributors, dedicated to bringing their customers the largest selection of quality horse supplements, products, and farrier supplies in Florida at affordable prices. Also online at ttdistributors.com. This hour of the Horse Talk Show is presented by Palm Chevrolet in Ocala. Experience the difference in buying. Palm makes it simple with no pressure, the best sales staff, and lots of inventory. Experience the difference at Palm Chevy in Ocala or online at palmchevrolet.com. Palm Chevy, find new roads.
Hi, this is Hall of Fame jockey Mike Smith. You're listening to the Horse Talk Show.
Back on the final segment of the Horse Talk Show, presented by Palm Chevrolet, your hometown Chevy experience. Thank you to Larson Farms, our broadcast sponsor, Idaho's finest alfalfa. And by the way, mentioning their alfalfa, I've got to mention their meadow hay, because I have this naughty little miniature horse who gets fat and roly-poly, as I mentioned to Dr. Chaot earlier, especially in the fall time when the grass kind of drops down. And that meadow hay is incredible. If you need to feed something that's not nearly so rich as the alfalfa, the meadow is incredible. Never been a big fan of coastal. This is definitely far, far upgraded from that, and seems to be perfectly safe for my fat little miniature horse. So if you're looking for something really good quality, the meadow hay is really, really amazing. I'm Louisa Barton in the studio. We've had a couple of really fun guests the last couple of segments. Been chatting to Ali Ortiz and Julia Suarez, and we've been chatting about the Pasifinos. Shared a few videos with us. If you're on Facebook, you can see some videos of the Pasifino breed. Tell us a little bit about what makes there's a lot to be said in the gate, but when you see a Pasifino becoming a world champion or at least excelling up into the top of the breed, what are some of the things that a judge is looking for in the breed for that horse to be in the winning spot?
Quickness, energy. Of course, the training is really important. No matter how great the horse is, it needs to have good training. You know, the beauty, the elegance, the tracking, the conformation.
Well-behaved.
Yeah.
The temperament. They could be very quick. It could have, could be a high quality horse, but if it doesn't behave well in the
show ring
or have good temperament, then the stallion or mare won't last long. So temperament, I think, has a lot to do.
They work really hard, Louisa. So some of those classes that like World Cup levels and national levels, when the class is taking long and there's so many horses in there, even some of the ones that you think can make it to the class, some of them start getting a little tired, but there's some that are just so energetic. They stay, they give you 100% the entire class.
There's some Pasifinos that will go in the show ring and it's like you told them, okay, we're going into the show ring, because they just transform. And then there's some that are amazing.
They know,
definitely.
Really?
I think that's a interesting and beautiful thing about Pasifinos is they really can put on a show.
They do.
It's like beautiful to watch. Yeah.
The music, the crowd, it just gives them more energy.
And the feel when you're on them, when you know they're gentle and you feel all that energy under you, and the music, it's
you'll
a great
thing. You'll have to get me on one.
You definitely have to ride one.
You do.
You know, anybody that wants to come see a Pasifino, they go on pasifinoocala.com. We have all our sponsor farms there. Pasifino people love to show people our Pasifino horses. We really want to educate people, because it's a little sad sometimes when we hear that people think this is a man-made breed. Lisa, it's not man-made at all. But I can understand it's just so rare to see that. You know, right? I mean, this is the only thing I think we could use
so
to
cute.
Show people that they do it since they're born.
Lovely.
And apart from Ali's farm, you already know one of my family members. I got about like five more that you can come to one of our farms and ride whenever you want.
That sounds lovely. I would love
Any
to
of us
would
be happy to have you. And honestly, we mean that for real, anybody wants to come to any of the Paso farms, if they go, we have our, you know, our email address, they can get a hold of me and Julia. We'll set them up with appointments wherever they want. They can see how the horses are well taken care of, how there's nothing artificial done to them. They're just great. They're amazing.
That's what I think differentiates the Ocala show from other regions. It's like we have so many big name farms here that, you know, if I were someone from another city, I would want to come here and go visit all those farms before the show, because, you know, they're all in the same place. They're all in the same vicinity. So you might as well go see all these big farms while you're here.
Yeah, and all these people do that all the time. They fly in from all the countries, Aruba, Curacao,
and they visit farm to farm.
They go to all the farms. Sometimes they come with a train ride shopping for a horse, and they may visit 12, 15 farms here in the Ocala area.
And they see other breed farms, like the beauty of other breed farms, and they're like, wow, Ocala is beautiful. And we're like, yeah, we know.
Send them my way. So Ocala Cup, December 4th to 8th?
4 to 6.
4 to 6. Any other things going on at the Ocala Cup that people can see? Are you going to have any kind of food vendors? Any shopping?
We are going to have food vendors, good. Latin food, and then we lovely. Got... Mima's Country Cooking, you know, they used to own Nelson's Trailer Sales. We have Colombian food, Puerto Rican food. Yeah, a little bit of everything. Yeah.
A little Vendor Village area, shopping?
Yes, some shopping, yes.
Lovely, yes. So it'll be a great
Actually, we're even looking for more vendors. So if anybody wants to give us a call, we'd love to get some more vendors out there at the show.
Yeah, it'd be a great spot to be, I would think.
Yes.
With all those people, you're going to do well.
Luisa, we're only charging $50 for the vendors, that's it. Because we just want to get a lot of vendors. So honestly, if anybody wants to give us a call, we got a great little coffee bar coming from Miami. It's adorable. It's a horse trailer, a two-horse trailer, and they turned it into a gorgeous coffee bar.
They came to one of our business after hours. I love it.
It's adorable.
I said, oh my gosh, that's a horse trailer.
We're having that too, and we saw the pictures because they sent it to us, like, so we'd approve them bringing, so we have that too.
That's
fine. Because it's probably going to be a little chilly and nice in the evening. So yeah, we got all kinds of food, the coffee bar.
Sweet.
Great fun. And spectators can just come and enjoy and watch it. And
we are working on something that was in Ocala. We're hoping we can put it together, the Ride of Paso. We've been back and forth, you know, because of the COVID. What do you think, Lisa?
I think with the
masks and...
Yeah, I think you should go for it.
Yeah, because we can, you know, anybody who wants to try them can wear a mask, and the handlers will be wearing a mask. So we're toying with that.
I think that's a great
Ocala idea. Style put that out there, and we're like, oh, it's in Ocala style. We should work
we
on
better
that.
Do it, yeah.
So we're actually, yeah, so you do think we should try
I
that
do.
Out. Okay.
I think
yeah, we could do it in the back arena at the pavilion. There's that back arena. We're trying to get a few horses, very laid back, gentle horses, to be able to possibly do it and let people try out.
The experience.
Yeah.
Yes.
That's wonderful.
Yeah.
A couple of quick mentions. Don't forget, it is Farm to City Week. This week has been a real a special week, and the Conservation Summit tomorrow, I'm very excited about that. Reminders about the Florida Thoroughbred Transformation Expo as well. That's actually the scavenger hunt for Farm City Week, so you can check that out. I absolutely love working with UF on these things, and certainly our farms are very important. And of course the summit, which is tomorrow. And that's the Thoroughbred Transformation Expo coming up December 11th to 13th. So we've got lots of good stuff going on here in Ocala over the next couple of weeks. That's not even including the Thanksgiving holiday that's coming up as well. So we've certainly got a lot of exciting things. Don't forget the Stirrups and Strides Reverse Raffle Fall Fundraiser, $100 a ticket. Help them fundraise this year, since they're not able to have some of their events that they use for fundraisers. So grand prize there of $5,000, and don't forget it's $9,000 in prize money at the Florida Thoroughbred Transformation Expo. And then in January we'll be starting back up with our hit season, as well as air show jumping as well. A couple of weekends in January, we'll have more information on air show jumping for you in the next few weeks as well, and have Billy Worthington in the studio. Ladies, I want to thank you so much.
Thanks for having
actually me. A wealth of information about the Pasofino breed. I even learned some new things myself about them. I'm excited about a chance to ride. I'll get Gigi to record it, and then we can put it up on the show.
That will be fun.
Pasofino,
let's do that for sure.
It certainly looks like an exciting, fun ride, and they have a wonderful temperament.
Oh, yes. They do. They do.
We hope to see you at the show.
Oh, I'm definitely going to be there. Yeah. I'm going to really enjoy. I'm really looking forward to the Sunday. I really like to see the
Oh, that'll be a great day. Yes. It's going to be beautiful.
Yes, yeah. Wonderful. Ali, Julia, thank you both so much for being with us. Don't forget about the Ocala Cup in that first week in December. It'll be a lot of fun. You'll really enjoy it. Come out to the Livestock Pavilion and watch 300 or 400 Pasifinos in action. It'll be a great fun time. You'll really enjoy yourself. Whether you're in Ocala, Marion County, Florida, the horse capital of the world or not, happy horsing around until the